Exploring is one of humankind's great drives. We have moved from the plains of Africa to every terrain on the planet imaginable, including mountains, swamps, jungles, and deserts. But can we take the next step and adapt ourselves to life outside the planet? It's been almost a half century since we first set foot on the moon, but only recently have advances in propulsion, computer, and medical technology finally made such colonization possible. With reusable rockets, moon shuttles, and talk of spacecraft headed to Mars, colonizing space is quickly moving from science fiction to science reality. Beside the urge to explore, colonizing space would allow advances in manufacturing and provide access to a number of resources. The moon is a rich source of silicon, aluminum, and titanium, and there are now asteroid mining companies preparing to extract minerals such as platinum, potentially worth trillions of dollars. The two most likely places to live would be an orbiting space station and Mars. You might be surprised that I didn't include the moon, but there's a good reason. While the moon has a number of natural resources for building, there are not many for living. It would be preferable to live in a nearby space station and simply visit the moon for materials as needed. If we were to live in space, it's not just adapting the environment to suit us. We would also have to adapt ourselves to suit the environment. There are a number of ways that space and zero gravity affect the human body, ranging from muscle atrophy to cosmic radiation causing dementia. Where would space colonization eventually lead? We have already found other planets capable of supporting life, though it would likely take centuries of traveling to get there. This suggests that we may have to induce hibernation or else artificially prolong our lives. We've taken only the first step in exploring the stars, but while merely a small step for humans, it will soon be a giant leap for humankind.